Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with your Monday Photoshop tutorial. How many of you use the Swatches panel on a regular basis in Photoshop? If you do, leave me a comment down below and let me know. But I'm surprised at how many people don't use this feature at all. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how this panel works, how it can benefit you, and a new feature that was introduced in Photoshop CS6 13.1, which allows you to import colors from a CSS or HTML document. It's quite fantastic. Let's take a look. First, just like the rest of Photoshop's panels, your swatches can be found on the right-hand side of your workspace. Or if you don't see them there, you can activate it under the Window menu at the top. In short, the Swatches panel allows you to quickly select and save colors that you use often in your projects. When you first install Photoshop, many common colors are available as swatches, and clicking on any of them will activate that color as your foreground color, as seen at the bottom of the tools bar. Now, if you hold down your Command or Control key, Command on the Mac, Control on Windows, any swatch that you click will become the background color instead of the foreground color. So a simple left click will define your foreground color, add in your Command or Control key, and you'll define your background color. Now usually, especially when using the eyedropper tool, holding down Alt or Option and clicking will assign the background color. But in the Swatches panel, holding down Alt or Option allows you to quickly delete a swatch. You'll notice when I position my cursor over top of a swatch, and then I hold down my Option key on my Mac, a scissors icon appears, indicating that when I click, that swatch will be deleted. You can also drag a swatch to the trash icon, but that's no fun. Now, in terms of creating a new swatch, you first need to set your desired foreground color in the color picker. This can be done using the eyedropper to sample a color on an open image. You can adjust the hue using the up and down slider and then set the brightness and saturation by dragging the circle to your final choice, or you can enter a hex value at the bottom right. If you're into flat design, flatuicolors.com is a simple website that will allow you to copy a hex code directly to your clipboard simply by clicking on the color of your choice. Let's copy carrot. And then when you're back in Photoshop, pasting it into the hex field will create that color. Now that your foreground color is set, to create a new swatch, you can either click on the Create New Swatch icon or click on an empty area in the Swatches panel. This will bring up a dialog box allowing you to name that new swatch. Let's stick with carrot. Now if you don't care too much about the name, holding down Alt or Option while creating a new swatch will skip the naming dialog box completely. Just like most panels in Photoshop, a menu can be revealed at the top right corner of the Swatches panel. This is where you can change the way you view your swatches, you can reset, load, and save your swatches, and you can access the packs that Adobe has included with Photoshop. Selecting any of these preset packs will give you the option to append or add them to your list. Append will place the new swatches at the end of your current ones, or pressing OK will replace them completely. One of the smaller features that was added with Photoshop CS6 13.1 is the ability to create swatches from a CSS or HTML document. If you're a web designer, you may already have a CSS or HTML file on hand, but if you run across a website like FlatUI Colors, this will allow you to grab all the colors at once. For this page, we'll want to grab the CSS file, which can be usually found within the source of the website. On Google Chrome, right-clicking on the page and choosing View Page Source will bring up the page's HTML document, where you can usually find the CSS file referenced towards the top. Click on the CSS link, and then save that file somewhere to your computer. Now back in Photoshop, under the Swatches Panels menu, you can load in that CSS file, which will bring in all the colors that were used on that page. And just like you learned earlier, clicking on any of the swatches will turn that into your foreground color. And just in case you're worried about losing your new swatches, you can save them as a backup or to share with your friends. And that's the Swatches panel in Photoshop, a very simple way to add and access your most commonly used colors. And as of Photoshop CS6 13.1, you can now import colors from CSS or HTML documents. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope that helped. And if you want to be kept up to date on the new content that I produce, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, and I'll see you next time for another Photoshop tutorial.